are underway. Lookboonmee wearing the tie shorts, the Brazilian in the red, black, and gray camo. A
lot of movement coming from the Brazilian fighter. Lookboonmee seems to be staying calm, waiting for that opportunity to enter. Nice kick. Good
heavy
flurry.
Hands. Wow. Brazilian throwing some power there early.
She did say in her pre-fight interview that she thought kickboxing would be her strength here, which that's a pretty audacious thing to say, and I love that kind of that attitude bringing this to this cage.
There is something to be said about Muay Thai in that approach being different than a traditional kickboxing approach for mixed martial arts. Adriane does have the experience, and you know, she feels like her striking may be better when it comes to the mixed martial arts game.
And Lookboonmee threw a jump teep off of her rear leg and a jump round kick right there, finding those big, big shots. You can see Adriane is looking for those kicks to enter with those flurries. And that leg, I mean, she's getting hit hard with those kicks. Doesn't seem to register.
She's willing to eat a leg kick to throw a combination of five or six punches. We'll see how long that can last.
Both of them using fakes and fades, trying to pull out the answer from the other fighter, seeing what she's going to do.
Ooh. Hard kick to the body there, and the Brazilian answers again with some hands. Looking at Lookboonmee with her Thai background, this evasion there, and Adriane almost left her feet.
Yeah, she off-balanced her and then did a little bit of a crowd play there. You can see Lookboonmee actually, it looks as though, you know, she's been hitting those or attempting to hit those teeps to the body. She's targeting the liver, I think, with that over and over again, trying to wear her down and keep those flurries from happening, trying to get the bounce out of Adriane's step.
Tommy Tohol checking in on Twitter, one of our favorites here at Invicta FC. Nice attack there. See Adriane's posture, it's just aggressive. Even her feints are aggressive, but she needs to be wise here. Again, attacking the body is Lookboonmee.
Yeah, and it looks as though Lookboonmee has found kind of that range for that kick. She knows how to get that stop in or that off-balancing that's been spinning Adriane around.
Now getting confident, I think, is Lookboonmee. Trying to say with her Muay Thai background, you know, she has a lot of dynamic kicks, not the traditional kicks that you might see every day in mixed martial arts. Again, attacking the body with that teep.
Adriane throwing a flurry at her, landing some good shots, but ultimately being taken down by the Thai fighter.
And Lookboonmee said, look, I really enjoy mixed martial arts. I enjoy all aspects of mixed martial arts. And you see that sometimes, Julie, with traditional strikers, when they get these new tools, like a ground game or wrestling, ground and pound, they like to experiment with that because it's something new. She has 300 Muay Thai fights, and now she can take people down and try to punch them in the face. She's excited about that.
And so many of those techniques actually translate very well to grappling, or to MMA grappling, I should say. You know, clinch work, the elbows and stuff like that. She can get to a position on the ground a lot of the time to really throw an elbow, a quick elbow over the top, as she does there. Adriane was trying to keep her tied up with overhooks. Lookboonmee was able to get inside control for a second and really get that elbow in there. Now you can see she's using the brace with her right hand to slam down and then push the head down.
We mentioned Lookboonmee trains with Mallory Martin. If you know Mallory Martin, she is fierce with the ground and pound, and I'm sure she's gone over these drills and imparted some of her knowledge with Loma's MMA game.
And you can see Adriane was trying to stay like Velcro to the body of Lookboonmee, really stay tight so that she can't get the space. All she needs is a little bit of space to get that basing position and slice those elbows in.
Adriane trying to use that knee shield to improve her position.
It's a good strategy if she can get that other foot out.
Lookboonmee disengages, lets her back to the feet. 30 seconds remain here in round number one.
There's still a bounce in Adriane's step. She doesn't want Lookboonmee to get that read on her, but you can see her distancing is a little bit different now. She's staying back.
And the posture needs to change because Lookboonmee has shown, look, I'm going to kickbox you, but I could also take you down at any moment, and you got to respect both of those approaches.
MMA, man.
All right, round two underway. Brazil's Monique Adriane, Thailand's Loma Lookboonmee. Lookboonmee has been competing in combat sports since she was 8 years old. First fight was near the ocean. She adopted the name Loma. First time she had seen the ocean, and Loma means dolphin. Kick again there by Lookboonmee.
And you can see Adriane's trying to find that distancing again for those punches. Lookboonmee's pulling back a little bit. I mean, her chin's even a little bit high there. She's not afraid of those punches. And they look like they hit pretty hard. But her distancing now, she's getting that timing. And Adriane's having to reach more on those punches, especially that right hand. She's reaching out a little bit too far now.
A lot of feints here by the Brazilian, trying to maybe get a reaction to Lookboonmee.
Also trying to keep her from getting a read on those targets. Doesn't appear to have worked right there. She got hit with a leg kick and another teep.
Nice combination. Finish with a kick to the lead leg of Lookboonmee. As you mentioned, Adriane said, hey, I think I have the advantage of the kickboxing department.
And I think that was very nicely done right there. She's trying to read that kick and throw those punches again, but she's getting a little bit more confident in taking the center of the ring now, or the center of the cage, excuse me, as she did in the beginning of the first round. I think she's finding some timing there, too. She's finding some distancing there. Nice right hand in that flurry.
If she ate the kick to the body and snapped the head back, Loma looked at me.
And those body shots, they add up. She's still bouncing. She doesn't look like she's been affected by them yet, but you have to wonder, you know, how that's going to be affecting her breath if they go to a third round.
Just under 8 minutes remaining in the overall fight. They say that, you know, shots to the body and leg can be money in the bank. Loma has attacked the body more than the leg in this round. Would you like to see her change things up and maybe inhibit the mobility of Adriane?
Yeah, and she has actually changed things up a little bit in throwing her right hand back. She's landed two solid rights right there. I don't know. It'd be interesting to see Lookboonmee move forward a little bit more. You can see Adriane's going to try and catch that teep now. I think that's a good thing to do. Even if she doesn't quite get the leg, she deflects some of the power. Nice.
Nice takedown there by Adriane. Loma throwing some right hands when she was just on one leg, but now has to work off her back.
And this is where her elbows are going to come in handy, but it's also she won't get quite the leverage unless she pushes that head away. So Adriane, using her head to pin Lookboonmee up against the cage, is smart. She should definitely look for a pass, look for a better position than just the guard from here. We saw Lookboonmee in her debut with Invicta is actually quite good at using the cage to climb back to her feet.
Staying tight is Adriane here. Not letting Lookboonmee break off the angle there. It looked like Lookboonmee was trying to maybe attack that left arm, but Adriane shutting it down with her head.
And Lookboonmee has a right butterfly hook, just inserted the left. Oh, pushed on the hip.
Adriane disengages, kept the pressure on Lookboonmee, but is able to stand now back at space.
And with that takedown, with some of that control from top position, she's trying to put some points in the bank there for the judges and show that she can put the other fighter on her back and, you know, kind of even things up if they score high for that takedown in the first round. Oh, ooh. Nice reversal.
Mistake there by Adriane. Lookboonmee in the mount. Nicely done to initiate that scramble by the Brazilian. Now back on the feet.
Nice jockeying for head position. Beautiful throw.
Nicely done by the Thai native.
You can see she's wrapping up over that hand. She's looking for a way to, as she's pinning the elbow, she's looking for a way to flatten her out, but also get some strikes along the way.
And this is big for Loma to get this position here, the latter part of the round. Adriane was in control earlier in this round. Now some big left hands there by Lookboonmee.
And Adriane gets at least a half regard, full regard now, but she suffered some damage, and that was some spectacular wrestling and kind of jockeying around there on their feet from Lookboonmee.
Judges tend to remember what happened in the final moments of a round and sometimes forget effective offense earlier in the round. And Loma Lookboonmee trying to finish this second round in a big way.
Adriane is trying to, she was trying to set up a triangle. Lookboonmee disengages back on her feet for the final seconds of the round. Big
exciting Adam Wade action here in this final 5 minutes. We'll see what happens.
Yeah, and excuse me, a little bit of wear there on the face of Monique Adriane. You can see some of those shots were really getting to her. Still bouncing.
A lot of respect here early on, broken by a kick from Adriani.
Mm-hmm. Hard kick there, and then Lookboonmee with that teep to the body. I'm watching Adriani's left leg, and she seems to be bouncing okay, but she's eaten a lot of damage to that leg, and I'm wondering if it's inhibiting some of her, you know, strong lateral pushes. It doesn't seem to be, but her movements do seem a little bit smaller, maybe not as I guess, gaining as much ground with her footwork.
Would you like to see that still be a focal point for Lookboonmee to attack it here? We're in the latter, you know, part of the fight here, round number three.
Always. I love seeing people eat each other's legs up like that. I think it's great, and it also gives us that opportunity for Adriane to let her hands go. I think she wants those leg kicks to open things up, to grab the leg or to throw that right hand. Nice head kick.
Nice kick to the body there by Lookboonmee. Adriane pushes forward, now into the clinch.
Now here up against the cage, ooh.
Elbows on the inside.
Yeah, against the cage here, it's definitely gonna be about inside control and getting the other person down. Inside control gives those elbows, and it prevents that takedown. Look at Lookboonmee's hips. She pulled out like that. Adriane very wisely disengaged once Lookboonmee was at an angle there. For Adriane to kind of come back, she should really have that second, the counter to the counter attack. Lookboonmee pull out her attack, go over the top of those punches, and then find that counter attack when Lookboonmee does her teep or throws her teep.
Adriane wisely circling to the left side of Lookboonmee. That's not the power side. Very aware of where the strikes are coming from Lookboonmee.
And Lookboonmee holds her hand so low, targeted in the liver, very nice. Holds her hand so low, so much confidence for having eaten quite a few punches.
And both these ladies showing their durability. Nice left hand there, combination by the Brazilian Adriane.
And what added real spice to that is she stepped out at that angle to the left as well, giving her more space if she wanted to attack with another right hand.
I think you're really seeing the differences between a traditional kickboxing approach from Adriane and then that Thai approach here from Lookboonmee, but really a well-rounded mixed martial arts attack throughout this fight by both ladies. Touch over 2 minutes remaining here in the fight.
Lookboonmee just enters right in, hands in front of her for that knee.
I mean, the composure by this young lady, 23 years old, over 300 fights. It's going to be hard to get her rattled inside the cage.
It is, and I must say, Adriane is disciplined in her attacks. She's doing a game plan, like she's executing a game plan. It may not be working in every, you know, every exchange, but she's coming back to it, keeping her hands up, staying with a bounce, staying moving, finding those shots when she can, trying to grab. I mean, it's a good game plan. She's just not quite there on the range at times.
Evenly matched fight. 90 seconds remain in this third and final round. Lookboonmee coming forward again with that kick.
And there's some swelling under the right eye of Adriane.
Adriane threw a kick at her right hand for her troubles.
She's looking a little bit more tired now too, a little bit less balanced.
Nice right hand there for the Brazilian.
That was fantastic. Coming in with that lead elbow and then that punch same time.
So much on the line here. Really anything big could sway the judges, maybe steal this fight. Beautiful takedown there by Lookboonmee, half guard. Trying to use that knee shield is Adriane.
And she's got to really use that, generate enough space that her face isn't there for those elbows or, you know, she doesn't give up enough space to pass. You can see she lost the knee shield there and is wrapped up in the half guard now, trying to keep control of Lookboonmee's posture.
Less than 20 seconds remain. Lookboonmee going to work with some elbows, punches. Nice hard strike there. Final 10 seconds.
Very nice transition. The two punches there, coming to the elbow over the top, then getting her head back down and covering the mouth. Oh, that's some mean fighting right there, TJ. Mean fighting.
That is what the atomweight division is all about. Julie, walk us through some of this action.
We can see she's still looking for those big shots. She throws that right hand. Mouthpiece is coming out just a little bit right there. She adjusts it. Lookboonmee's looking for that takedown. She wraps around, and I think, yeah, that might be where the knee went when she wrapped around. The Thai wrestling is so underrated, and the things that can happen with balance in the clinch, the way Thai fighters learn to off-balance you in the clinch, sweeping the knee at that angle can really cause damage. And let's see. Yep, she's wrapped up there, and she's yanking down over. Wow, it looks like the foot was caught in one position, and the knee went the other position, and that looks painful.
Hard to watch as Adriane still fought valiantly through that injury. The fight wasn't over at that moment. She was still defensive, obviously in a lot of pain and still getting some attention.
Ladies and gentlemen, having gone the distance, we go to the scorecards. All three judges are in accordance, 30-27 for your winner by unanimous decision. Loma Lookboonmee.
Loma Lookboonmee getting it done.